सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। ओम। पेज 37 वर्स 48 टॉप वर्स। विसर्गाद्या स्मशानान्ता भावादेहस्य नात्मनः कलानामिव चन्द्रस्य कालेनाव्यक्तवर्त्मना कालेन ह्योघवेगेन भूतानां प्रभवाप्ययौ नित्यावपि न दृश्येते आत्मनोऽग्नेर्यथार्चिषाम्। The 49th shloka, we have taken it as 48th shloka, which we were seeing in the last class. Afterwards, I have to talk about 49th shloka. So that's why I read the shlokas, both of them together. There is a nice shloka which connects to this topic, where the Avadhuta is a great sadhu, mahatma, who is talking to the Yadu about his experiences and the lessons what he has learned in his life. So that shloka is not in this book, but it is separately connected to this, about sadhus, mahatmas, great people, great souls. Sadhus are those people who are always related themselves to Bhagavan. They never look at themselves separate from Bhagavan. They always think about Bhagavan, they always one with Bhagavan, they never see themselves separate from Bhagavan. They are called sadhus. If you also think like that, you are also a sadhu, without dadi, without saffron. Everyone can become a sadhu. Every bhakta is a sadhu. Every bhakta is a sadhu. We think sadhu means who is wearing saffron clothes and having jata, jutam and dadi. But that concept is not totally right. He may be is appearing as sadhu, but the real sadhutvam is phalakaryam sadhnoti iti sadhuhu. Pujya Swamiji's statement is this. When Swamiji came to our place in T. Nagar, many of you have also attended that program. Swami said one statement, sadhu is one who accomplish many things in his or in her life. Phalakaryam sadhnoti. It is sadhu, not Tamil sadhu. Okay, Tamil sadhu is innocent, ignorant person, paavam. Not that sadhu here. Phalakaryam sadhnoti iti sadhu. And that sadhu, that shloka, sadhunam darshanam punyam. Tirthabhutahi sadhavaha. Kalena phalate tirtham. Sadhuhu sadhyaha sadhuhu samagamahan. A beautiful shloka. That's why I want to share with you. Sadhunam darshanam punyam. Just mere darshanam. Looking at them, seeing at them itself is great punyam. If your parvai, your vision, just see that Mahatma, your eyes fall on that Mahatma, you got a lot of punya. You got it. That is that shloka says, sadhunam darshanam eva punyam. Eva you can supply. Darshanam eva punyam. What to talk of listening their words and approaching them, serving them, what to talk of that much punyam? Darshanam punyam sadhunam tirtha bhutahi sadhavaha. Why it is so much giving merit, their darshanam? Merit means punyam. Because they are all like tirthakshetrams. Normally Rameshwaram, Kanyakumari, Haridwar, Rishikesh, if you go there, you get lot of punyam. Because they are all tirthakshetras. By stepping there, you are accumulating punyam, lot of punyam. Tirtha bhutahi sadhavaha. Sadhus are like Mahatmas, sadhus. Therefore, kalena phalate tirtham. But there is a difference between that tirtha and sadhu tirtha. That tirtham also gives punyam. Here tirtham means a river where there is a temple where people go and worship the Lord. After taking bath in that river, that is called tirtham. Of course, in temple also he gives tirtham. You get punyam by sipping that tirtham. This tirtham gives punyam later. Kalena phalate tirtham. That punya what you have acquired by going to tirthakshetrams, that phalam comes later after your death. Phalate means it fructifies, it gives phalam later in next janmas, janmas. Phalate kalena, kalena phalate tirtham. Whereas sadhyaha sadhuhu samagamaha. Meeting the sadhus and talking to them, approaching them and serving them, just looking at them, sadhyaha. There and then and there, it gives punyam. Phalam also. Punyam na adrishta phalam. Here, this punya is drishta phalam. You get a tremendous mental peace and you get a lot of clarity in your thinking and your future, everything is very smooth. Sadhyaha means then and there. Now here itself, where there is that sadhu darshanam, there and there, sadhu samagamaha, that nice sloka. That is why in our culture, people always love to approach sadhu. In the last class I said, why people go to sadhu? Because of this reason. This sloka I couldn't give in the last class, therefore I want to cover that now. Nice shloka, isn't it? We have to remember, but we have to remember. Now, in this shloka, 49th shloka, which we have taken it as 48th shloka, 5th guru, that is fire only, Dattatreya, concluding his 5th guru, who is the guru for him, through whom he has learned a lesson. He is comparing that fire. From fire, the flames rise and disappear. They rise and subside, rise and subside. As they rise, immediately after some time they disappear. Archisham means flames. Yatha, just as the flames, but their arrival and disappearance, when they are rising and disappearing, it is not visible. When they rise, when they disappear, it is not predictable. No. So, nityau api na drishyete, it appears as though real, but it is not real. The flames, their arrival and departure, they are very, very unpredictable, and they disappear. Drishyete, they appear. Comparing to that, kala, the life also of these beings, bhutanam, all living species, 84 lakhs of species who are all having bodies. Bhutanam, all the bodies, they are also having prabhava apyayau. Prabhava means birth, apyaya means death, arrival and departure. It is also how, just as the waves, great floods comes and just they recede. Ogha vegena, kalena ogha vegena. Kala is that compared to ogha vega. Ogha means wave, tidal wave. Suddenly it rises and suddenly it disappears. How fast it rises, vega, so fast. And so fast it recedes. As it rises and it recedes. Like that only our lives also, our bodies, bubbles are also like that only. For some time they come and immediately in course of time they disappear. Kalena vegena, ogha vegena. Here kala is that which is the speed, time. The time speed is unpredictable, it is not visible. As the baby born, 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, 2 years, grown up, school, college, PhD, over. Earning money, children, family, everything, over. So many years we think, but the span of life so fast. That is why the time, the watch, 1 hour when you sit here in the class, 11 o'clock I start Sadasiva Samarambham. And many times students says, Oru mani neram eppadi ponadhe theriyala Swami. Oru mani neram pohala, actually. It has not gone. We have become old 1 hour. That is the fact actually. The time watch what we are wearing, the pointers are showing the time. Really speaking, kala is invisible. Kala is invisible. See the fact here, how logical it is. The time, the pointers are in the small pin and bigger one, longer one. One is showing hours, another one is showing minutes. Another one is showing seconds. All these are only indicators of the time, but really speaking, can you visualize the time? Can you see that time? Invisible time it is. You cannot see it. They are only the indicators. You say now 11:12, 11:15, you go on telling like that, but they are only indicators. Are you really seeing the time? None of us seeing the time. No, no, I am seeing time, Swamini. You are not seeing time. You are seeing the watch. In that watch, I am seeing time, Swamini. In that watch, you are seeing the pointers, not the time. No, Swamini. Time only I am seeing. No, you are seeing the pointers who are indicating the invisible time. Visible pointers are indicators of the invisible time. None of us can see that time. It is just like saying, I see the space. No. You cannot see the space because it is formless. How can you see the formless space? Similarly, how can you see the formless time? Time par evalachena. People say, no? Time par evalachena. Tamil. See the time, what is now time? How can I see the time? I see the only indicators, points of that number. We have given the numbers to that time, but there is no form for time. No one can see. Kalena, Ogha, Vegena, Prabhava, Apyayau. That is why Kala is a mysterious phenomenon in the creation. None of us try to analyze because we will disappear in course of time by analyzing the time. That's why we don't bother about that analysis of time and all. Edo time varudhu porudhu avladha. But we are not having that much stamina to study about that time. But Vedanta analyzes lot about time. We compare, that is why Kala always compared like a Chanabhanguram, Budbudaprayam. These are all words they use. How fast Kala moves. Budbudaprayam, like a bubble. Chanabhanguram, like a fraction of seconds. These are the nice words, euphemistic words we use to manage the time. Anyhow. So the fifth guru is over. Now comes the next guru, the sixth guru. We will read the shloka 49, the top shloka we have read. I think I can give the meaning. We have already completed that. Now I have to give the meaning of this shloka. Beautiful shloka. Chandra is his sixth guru. Dattatreya Maharshi says, Dattatreya Bhagavan or Muni or Mahatma, whatever name you call, he tells to Yadu, oh Yadu Maharaja, I took this Chandra as my guru because Chandra taught me a lesson. What lesson Chandra taught? What lesson I have learned from Chandra? Chandra has got Kala. Prathama, Dvitiya, Tritiya, Chaturthi, Panchami. Like that there are digits. Kala called digit. Prathama, Tidhi, Dvitiya, Tidhis are there, no? 15. Again, expanding, waxing and veiling. From Prathama to Shukla Paksha to Krishna Paksha. Shukla Paksha 15 days, Krishna Paksha 15 days. So the sun is waxing and waning. The digits are increasing one by one, one by one, one by one. After 15 days, that Pauranami comes. Again from Pauranami, after on next day onwards, it is receding. Each kala is decreasing one by one until Amavasya. This is called waxing and waning, they call. Pournami and Amavasya, the digits of that Chandra, they appear and they disappear. Every month we are seeing, every month, that moon, Tadiya moon, all the days, every day moon we see, that digits are coming and again decreasing. That kalas are not real. Chandra is real. Kalas are not real. Just a comparison. Similarly, the bodies are not real. Atma is real. This is the lesson what Dattatreya learned. None of us have learned this lesson. Pournami celebration, Amavasya Tarpanam, so many things people are doing. How many people learned this lesson? Tell me. Are these digits of Chandra, are they really real? They are not really real. They are only just appearance. That is what he has learned. Now look into the shloka. व्यक्तवर्त्मना कालेन व्यक्तवर्त्मना मीन्स हूज मूवमेंट्स वर्त्मा मीन्स मूवमेंट वे ऑफ मूवमेंट्स आर हूज वे ऑफ मूवमेंट्स इज नॉट विजिबल कालेन अव्यक्तवर्त्मना नॉट व्यक्तवर्त्मना अव्यक्तवर्त्मना कालेना मीन्स हियर यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड 15 डेज डिजिट्स आर इंक्रीजिंग 15 डेज डिजिट्स आर डिक्रीजिंग रिसीडिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड कालेना अव्यक्तवर्त्मना देहस्य चंद्रस्य सो नाउ देह इज कंपेयर टू दिस कला देहास आर आल्सो कमिंग एंड गोइंग दे आर आल्सो कमिंग एंड गोइंग कलानाम इव लाइक कलास चंद्र कला कला आल्सो करेक्ट ओनली बट चंद्र कला द कला लकार इज देर इन तेलुगु in Sanskrit, in Tamil also there, lakara. In all languages it is not there. Okay, kala or kala. Beautiful word, kala. So, digits of the moon, kalanam, chandrasya kalanam, iva. Like the digits of the moon. Iva means like. Chandra must be compared to Atma. Chandra must be compared to Atma. Chandra Kala must be compared to Deha. Chandra Kalas comes and goes. Kalas comes and goes. Bodies also comes and goes. Chandra is a same. And it is a shadow. It is a shadow. It as though decreasing. Really, they are not happening in the Chandra. Similarly, Chandra like Atma, in Atma, this body is coming, going like Kala, Kala vat, digits vat. If one digit la irukko, next janma innor digit. So the digits are coming and going. Kalanamiva, Chandrasya Kalanamiva, Visargadhyaha, Visarga means janma. आदिपदात् वर्धते विपरिणमते अवक्षीयते विनश्यति नाशान्ताः स्मशानान्ताः स्मशानान्ताः अंटिल द क्रिमेशन ग्राउंड अंटिल द क्रिमेशन ग्राउंड फ्रॉम बर्थ ऑनवर्ड्स अप टू अंटिल डेथ स्मशानान्ताः मीन्स अंटिल डेथ நாஷாந்தாகன்னா பரவாயில்ல ஸ்மசானாந்தன்னா கொஞ்சம் பயமாக இருக்கும் அந்த வேர்டு பிடிக்காது நமக்கு ஸ்மசானம் வந்தாலே பிடிக்காது ஸோ நாஷா ஸ்மசானா போத் ஆர் ஒன் அண்ட் த சேம் இஸ் இட் நாட் வென் நாஷா கம்ஸ் தே ஒன் டேக் யூ டு ஸ்மசானா ஓகே ஸ்மசானாந்தாக அன்டில் டெத் ஃப்ரம் பர்த் ஆன்வர்ட்ஸ் அன்டில் டெத் In between growth and decay, all of them, bhavaha, dehasya eva, natu atmanaha, na atmanaha. They are not really belong to atma. The bodies which are coming and going, really speaking, they do not belong to atma. They belong to only deha. All dehas, just like waves, they come and they disappear. Hey, Yadumaharaja, I learned this lesson by seeing the Chandra. Just as Chandra is one and the same all the time, his digits are just coming and going every month. We are seeing non-stop. And a person sees 80 moons, like that full moons. And in Chole, that's a celebration. Celebration pandra, in the Gnana Matra Varla. This Chandra Darshanam, what I am seeing, it is waxing and wailing, bodies are like that. ఐది ఆత్మా ఐఎమ్ లైక్ చంద్ర వట్ ఎ లెసన్ హీ హాస్ లెర్న్డ్ దేర్ ఫోర్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఫాలో నౌ హూమ్ దత్తాత్రేయ నౌ వన్ వర్డ్స్ ఇఫ్ యు సీ ద మూన్ యు హ్యావ్ టు రిమెంబర్ హూమ్ దత్తాత్రేయన్ చెల్లకూడదు ఐ హ్యావ్ టు రిమెంబర్ మై ఆత్మా నేచర్ But naturally, when you look at the moon, now today onwards, you remember Dattatreya and Swamini class. Really speaking, what you have to remember? You have to remember only Atma, who is compared to the Chandra. I am not the body, Kala-like body, Digit-like body, but I am चंद्रवत आत्मा नेक्स्ट श्लोक विल रीड सम पीपल आफ्टर रीडिंग नेक्स्ट श्लोक आई विल टेल यू ओके इन माय माइंड थॉट्स आर जस्ट गशिंग आउट ओके
गुणैर्गुणानुपादत्ते यथा कालं विमुञ्चति न तेषु युज्यते योगी गोभिर्गा इव गोपतिः
What I want to say, connected to this only, whenever people visit this Mantralaya and Ramana Maharshi Ashram, like that places, where are there are samadhis of great Mahatmas, when they visit that place, generally they comment, they make a statement that Raghavendra Swamiji is alive. He is there, he is moving around in that place. This is the people's opinion. Even Ramana Maharshi Ashram also, when they go, Ramana Maharshi is there, still alive, he is moving there. Like that. Not, this is only a sample I am telling. There are hundreds of Mahatmas, like people, they think like this in many places of about many Mahatmas. Now you see the illogicality of this statement. We have to understand as a Vedantic student, I have to understand the illogicality or fallacy of this statement. Suppose Raghavendra Swami is enlightened soul. He is an Jnani. Suppose he is moving there, with what he is moving? Physical body is not there, that you know and I know, everyone knows. He is not moving with physical body. If he is moving with gross physical body, you can see, I can see, everyone can see. That is sure, he is not moving with what? Physical body. Gross physical body he is not moving with. Then he is moving like what? Like a sukshma shariram he has to move, isn't it? Because sukshma shariram is invisible. Therefore, he is moving in invisible form. We cannot see the form, but he is moving. Ghost ani cholla matom, adha. He is moving. Suppose he is moving like a sukshma shariram, for example. Okay, vechukalam. He is moving like a sukshma shariram without gross body. He is moving and he is blessing the bhaktas. This subtle body, if he continues to move, he is muktaha or baddhaha? Tell me. Baddhaha. He is no more a jnani. You cannot call him as an enlightened person or a jnani or jivan muktaha. If you say his subtle body is moving there, is blessing us, and you are making fool of yourself and you are making Raghavendra also fool. No. What a mistake people are doing just by statements. You should not do such a, make such a statements. You means people. I am telling you won't do that. People, outside people. Just like that they should not blabber, no? Meaningless statement. Suppose he moves like a sukshma sariram and there, that means you are indirectly telling he is not enlightened, he is not, he has not attained moksha, still he is in sukshma sariram. Who will be in sukshma sariram, tell me? Who will be in sukshma sariram? Ajnanis are only in sukshma sariram. And people talk about again incarnation. Again he has taken the body. Sukshma sarirama irundhu konja naal appuram he has taken the body. Adhu innum vera. Suppose he has taken the body means again sukshma sarira apdiye sarirama vandadanna enna artham? Avare mukti adayala thirupi vandaru edukkaga enna kooda sendradhukaga, because I am ajnani, he also come and join with me as ajnani anna. Therefore moving as a sukshma sariram is illogical. If he is a jnani, he can never move in his subtle body, or he can never take rounds there in that samadhi as subtle body, because no jnani will move with subtle body. Understand? Therefore no mahatma moves in this form of subtle body. Clear now? Logically clear? Shastrically also clear. This logical clearance I am giving based on Shastra. Our Shastra says Sthula Sharira Tyagaha Maranam Sukshma Sharira Karana Sharira Tyagaha Jnanena Sambhavati. Through Jnanam only you can drop Sukshma Shariram and Karana Shariram. Otherwise you cannot drop. A person who drops the Karana Shariram and Sukshma Shariram through Jnanam, he is only enlightened Jeevan Muktaha, Jnani, Brahmanishtaha he is. Whether he is in the body or in without body doesn't matter. He is a Jeevan Muktaha. Now understand. Therefore, Ramana Maharshi ahattam, innur Mahatma ahattam, yaar analam kuda, Jnani never move in any body, either Sukshma Shariram or Karana Shariram. He never moves. He knows that Karana Shariram is Mithya, Sukshma Shariram is Mithya. Of course, Thula Shariram already Mithya. He has falsified. So his bhaktas, real bhaktas also must understand what? Same what that Jnani has understood. This bhakta has to understand after wearing lot of Raghavendra Swami Chandan, Guruvayurappa Chandan, Raghavendra Swami Vibhuti, Guruvayurappan Vibhuti Chollamate, Chandan, whatever it may be they wear, one day or other they have to come to this knowledge. Clear? Now, in this verse 50 and 51, two shlokas, Dattatreya introducing his seventh guru, Suryaha. Suryaha, the 58th shloka, one way of presentation, and 51st shloka, philosophical presentation. Now let us see the Suryaha, what Surya does. Same like Mahatma also does. Second line you see, Gopatihi Gobhiga Iva, Gopatihi, Gopatihi means the Lord of Rays. Kiranapati, innoru per. Go means Kiranam, rays, R-A-Y-S, not R-A-C-E, R-A-Y-S, rays, Kiranams. That rays of sun is the pati of those Kiranams, because from sun only those Kiranams are coming. the rays are coming. Therefore, sun is called Gopatihi. Go means kiranams or rays. Their pati, the Lord, is called sun, Gopatihi. What Gopati does? Go means there are so many meanings. Cow is also go. That is one meaning is there. Another meaning is speech is also can walk, is also can be called go. And sense organs are also can be called as go. Go, no, not English go. Sanskrit go. Okarantaha. Okarantaha, strilingaha, goshabdaha, dvitiya bahuvachana. Here, gaha. Gaha means waters. Gaha. Here, ga means water. Same shabdam. Goshabdam only. Gaha. Gaha means waters. Gopati, the sun, draw the water through his rays in the summer. Up to last month, up to last month, March, April, May, June, July. How many months summer? Normally 2 months than every season should be there, Grishma Kalam. No, speciality of Madras. What? March, April, May, June, July, 5 months summer. Of course, no winter. Winter ஏ தெரியாது நமக்கு. We don't require any sweaters, we don't require any shawl, we don't require muffler. That's the speciality of Chennai. Always sweating. Okay. So, in that season, the sun draw the water from the ocean, from the earth. He draw the water and he keeps that water in clouds. Daily, அவர் கூட வேலை பண்ணிகிட்டே இருக்கார் பாவம். What he does, he takes the water from the earth, wherever water is there, it dries up. How do you know? நமக்கா தெரியாமலையா? We are experts in knowing that, because all our tanks are dried up, all our lakes are dried up, and all of us are drying up. Without water, how much struggle people are facing. So he has taken all water. He has taken all water. What he does? Does he keep that water with him? But when the time comes, yatha kalam, the time comes in rainy season from last 15 days, showering. He never keeps that water with him. So what? So what? Yogi is also, Jnani, Mahatma is also like, Vedantic students are also like. What do you say? Yogi, Natesh Yujjate, Son Bhagavan never keeps that water with him. I am the one who draw this water with so much difficulty. Therefore, let me hold this water. Never. He never think that I have drawn the water, now I am releasing the water. That bhavana is not there to the sun. Similarly, Jnani, the yogi, the mahatma, he uses his gunaihi gunan, his sense organs, and that situation, that place, at that time, they interact with the vishayas, sense objects. Sense organs draw some vishayas, sense objects. They learn sounds, shabdadi vishayaha. Gunaihi with sense organs, 10 sense organs. Not only jnana indriyani, even karma indriyani. Gunaihi, gunanu, sense objects. Adatte, upadatte, takes. Now you are doing what? Shabdam adatte, through your sense organ. Ear sense organ, you are drawing my sound. Upadatte. Similarly, you are looking at me, I am looking at you. Rupam upadatte. Rupam, shabda, rasa, gandha, all upadatte. even pen upadatte. You are taking pen, you are taking book, and you are walking. All sense organs of action also, they are also doing actions. And they are enjoying the, or experiencing those objects. Clear? All of us are doing from morning to till night. Same thing. Gunaihi gunan upadatte. Gunaihi means sense organs. Gunan means sense objects. Upadatte means experience. Yogi nateshu yujyate parantu vimunchati yathakalam. The moment the experience is over, he gives up that sound. Not boomerang, thinking about the same sound, same form, continuously. No. The jnani or yogi leaves that sounds, forms, taste, whatever he has taken, it leaves. Like sun leaves the water. Similarly, yogi also, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. All of them, whatever he received, immediately forgets. Immediately he drops. He never carries them in his mind. Like a child. How child remembers anything? Child forgets everything. Child vat ani sollala nam apply pannikalam. The baby is also never carry the past, all past experiences they never carry. Mother shouts at the baby, child never remember that, drops. Like that yogis also, they never be serious they of any experience. Ketya, over. Listen, and but don't leave the teaching, okay? That is why, Swamini, we are doing now. We are leaving the sounds, what we are teaching and chonna, customized. So, certain things, what are all not required, you have to drop. But unfortunately, our samsarathiki kaaranam enna theriyuma? We carry shabda, sparsha, roopa, rasa, gandha, months, years, decades. That is called samsara. Yogi never carries that. Forget there itself. That is what he does. Yatha kalam. As they come to experience, wonderful, fine. Over. Don't think about that. Yatha kalam vimunchati. The time comes, he drops it. That's all. When the time comes, the object comes, he experiences. When the time comes, he drops without brooding over them or thinking about them. Again, I want them. Vandada? Sari. Varliya? Sari. Pocha? Sari. Sari enna? Ellathi sari enna? Eppadi enna? Adhudha sari. Enna, if you think further, it carries what? Lot of dukkham. Next shloka. Here philosophical meaning he gives 51, 38th page.
Budhyate svena bhedena. Budhyate svena bhedena. Vyaktistha iva tadgataha. Lakshyate sthula matibhihi. Atma chavasthitorkavat. Arkavat. Vyaktisthaha. Like sun. Arka means sun. In previous verse, Gopatihi, sun. S-U-N. Okay. நமக்கு சன்னு சொன்னாலே சம்படி கம்ஸ் இந்த மாதிரி அவர் அவர் ஓன் சன்னு S-U-N சன் அர்க்க அர்க்க மீன்ஸ் சன் அர்க்கவத் லைக் சன் வக்திச்ச வக்தி மீன்ஸ் ஹியர் ரிஃப்ளெக்டிங் மீடியம் த பாடி Vyaktisthaha, available in the reflecting medium, the body. तद्गतः
मीन्स उपाधि प्रविष्ठः एज दो लाइक सन रिफ्लेक्शन टेक्स प्लेस इन द वाटर्स इन द मिरर मिरर इज अ मीडियम वाटर इज अ मीडियम सन रिफ्लेक्शन फॉल्स देयर यू सी एज दो सन इज देयर इन द मिरर सन इज देयर इन द वाटर्स सिमिलरली आत्मा स्वे भेदेन न बुध्यते यू शुड नॉट टेक दिस आत्मा इज रिफ्लेक्शन इन द बॉडी इन दिस बॉडी आत्मा इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग स्वे मीन्स आत्मा बाय इट्सेल्फ इट इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन दिस फिजिकल बॉडी देयर इन सटिल बॉडी इट इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग यू शुड नॉट टेक भेदेन दैट रिफ्लेक्टेड कॉन्शियसनेस Is it separate? Is it different? Na buddhyate. Bhedena na buddhyate. May you not take it as different from this original consciousness. Even though that is reflecting in the mind medium. Just like sun is reflecting in the mirror, do you take that sun mirror reflecting sun as different from that original sun? One sun is on the top, another sun is in the mirror, another sun is in the waters. Therefore, as many mirrors, as many water places are there, so many suns are there. Who says that? Dattatreya says, Sthula matibhihi lakshyate. This is the opinion of those people who are all having gross mind. Sthula matihi and manda buddhihi. Mandabuddhi, dull-witted people whose minds are so gross, who are not having intellectual sharpness, they alone consider there are so many suns, suryas are there, 100 reflecting mediums are there, mirrors are there, 100 reflected suns are there. Do you count there are 100 suns, 100 suryas are there, do you count 100 arkas, arka means sun? Who counts? Unintelligent people, gross-minded people, manda, sthula buddhi matihi lakshyate. They only take like that, not wise people. Just as you don't count that reflecting medium's reflected sun as different from the original sun, differently, they are not countable, there are no many sun reflection, they are only unreal, they are only appearance. Similarly, in all bodies, these are all mediums, one sun like Atma appearing in many bodies. Do you take there are many Jivatmas? Only one Paramatma appearing as Jivatma. But not really. This lesson are we learning from sun every day? Now start learning. How to learn? Keep water on the tubs, small tubs you take. Put over it 5 water tubs. Enna swamini water scarcity. And the water spoil ahead. Useful dhane. Keep that water under the sun. See the sun reflection. Do you count all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 suns? One sun, 5 reflections. They are not different. Similarly, I, the one Atma, appearing in mother-in-law's body. Adi chollanu first. I, the one Atma, appearing in brother-in-law's body, sister-in-law's body. I, the one Atma, only appearing in father-in-law's body, daughter, son, every body in everybody. I, the one Atma, only reflecting. Then how can I hate, how can I have a fear of anything? All are my reflections. Dvitiyadvai bhayam bhavati. उदरमंतरम कुरुते अध तस्य भयं भवति हूएवर डिफरेंशिएट वन सेल्फ फ्रॉम अदर्स द्वितीयाद्वै भयं भवति मैं मदर इन लॉ ना पूछ भयम पूज्य स्वामी जी जोक्युलरली सेस Some houses, when father is coming, children run away and hide behind the doors. ஏன் அப்பா வரார் அப்பா வரார் அப்பா வராருன்னு ஓடி அப்படியே தே ஹைடு பிஹைண்ட் த டோர்ஸ். ஆ அப்பா வராருன்னு நான் புள்ளியா என்ன லயனா ஏன் அப்பா வராருன்னு பயப்படி போகிறான்னு. த்விதீயாத்வை பயம் பவதி, ஒய்ஃப் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அஃப்ரைட் ஆஃப் யூ அண்ட் ஷே ஹேண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ஷேக்கிங் என்ன ஏன்ன லுக்கிங் அட் ஹஸ்பண்ட் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஒன்ஸ் ஓன் செல், லுக்கிங் அட் ஃபாதர் different from one's own self. Always a second thing limits you. Why? Where some people they go, they give happiness. Wherever they go, some people wherever they go, they give happiness. Some people whenever they go, they give happiness. And Swamiji says always like that, when the second thing comes in our life, which is so pleasant, அது போயிடுமோன்னு ஒரு பயம், அன்பிளசண்ட் திங் வந்துடுமோன்னு பயம். யாராவது லெட்டர் எழுதுனா வரேன்னு சொன்னால் ஐயோ வரானே வரானே பயம். சம் பீப்புள் கோயிங்கன்னா பயமாக இருக்கும். ஏன் என்ன எனி திங் செகண்ட் திங் லிமிட்ஸ் மீ. த்விதீயாத்வை பயம் பவதி சாந்தோக்கியம் உபனிஷத் சைஸ். உதரம் அந்தரம் குருத்தே என்ன உதரம் என்ன ஸ்டமக் இல்லை உது அறம் ஈவன் எ வி பிட் ஆஃப் separation, difference you do, there is a dukkham. Therefore, he says, hey, Yadu Maharaja, I never see anything different from me, like sun reflection in so many mediums, in so many bodies, I, the Atma, am reflecting. That's all. There is no second thing. I am non-dual Brahman. Where is the second thing to cause fear? Are insecurity in me? If I understand, that's important. If I understand. Next shloka. Now, up to here, the seven gurus description is over. Now we'll read. I hope I have given the meaning for all words. ஸ்தூலமதிபி ஆத்மா ச அவஸ்திதா அர்க்கவத். ஆத்மா இஸ் தேர் இன் எவரி பாடி, பட் மந்தமதி ஸ்டேக் தெம் ஆஸ் ரியல் ரியல் ரியல். பட் ஆல் மை ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் சொல்லிக்கலாமா, மை வேதாந்திக் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் ஆல் லுக் எட் எவ்ரி ஒன் ஆஸ் ஆத்மா ஓன்லி ஆஸ் ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன்ஸ் இன் த பாடீஸ். ஒன் ஒரிஜினல் ஆத்மா இஸ் சத்யம், all reflections are mithya. Verse 52. Nati sneha prasango vam kartavya kvapi kena chite kurvan vindeta santapam கபோத இவ தீனதீஹிம். அனதர் நைஸ் எக்ஸாம்பிள், பீசியன் எக்ஸாம்பிள், எ டவ். டவ்வன்னு இன்னொரு அர்த்தம் இருக்குது. டவ்வன்னு இந்த கோதுமை மாவு அது இல்லை. ஓகே, டவ் இஸ் லைக் பீசியன். கபோத பீசியன் புரா இன் சன் தமிழ் புரா. In Telugu, we call it as Pavuram. Pavuram. That Kapotaha example he gives here in the next shloka onwards. For that, before that, he is giving an introduction. He is going to take that story from this shloka onwards up to 74. Up to 74 shlokas he is going to talk about this kapota example, Pisian example, as 8th guru. He gives a suggestion: never have any attachment with anything, at any time, at any place, with anyone. Never have attachment.
na atisneha.
Over attachment drop. Never do over, never have any over attachment with anything. Atisneha. Mentally or physically. Here atisneha means mental togetherness. Mental togetherness. Thinking mentally, that person is with me, that thing is with me, that object is with me. Always I am associated with the object. That is called atisneha. Then prasangaha, companionship, togetherness physically. Prasangaha. Not speech here. Prasangaha means togetherness physically. Atisneha means mentally togetherness. Prasangaha, you have to supply ati. Ati prasangaha, physical togetherness. Camp pona kuda and the student in room la irukanum swami ne camp sadhana camp vandadenni adigala indha maadhiri ella paathi paathi camp venna nu vittitam thirupi start pannita malli thirupi adhe anubhavam varudhu enakku still same anubhava I am facing after living long gap. The same continuation, the same room, same student. Na idella paathi paathi and the room la pair podanum. I have to see their mentality also, their age also. One young, one old poda mudiyadhu. One high hyperactive, one very slow poda mudiyadhu. Ungalku enna theriyum enna kashtam illa camp vecha enna kashtam theriyumo idella solla mudiyadha kashtam yaaru யாரும் சொல்ல முடியாத கஷ்டம் குருவுக்கு. பட் ஐ டேக் இன் எ ஜாவியல் டைப். ஓகே, ஐ டோன்ட் டேக் இட் சீரியஸ்லி. எனி ஹவ், ஸோ ஒன்ஸ் இன் எ வை, லைக் என் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டி கம்ஸ் ஐ போர் அவுட். ஓகே, ஸோ ந அதிசயேன அதிஸ்னேகா ந கரணீயம், அதி பிரசங்கா அப்படி ந கரணீயம், ந கர்த்தவியா ந கர்த்தவியா. மே யூ நாட் have too much togetherness mentally or physically. Where? Kwapi, anywhere. Kena chit, with anyone. Anywhere, with anyone, you have to supply at any time. Yasmin kale api. Kurvan, suppose if anyone does that, if anyone does that, one should not do that. The too much togetherness of physical, mentally with anything at any time. If anyone does like that, suppose santapam dinadhihi kapotaiva, their life is miserable. Dinam dinadhihi, their life becomes dinadhihi kapotaiva. That kapota pigeon whose life became so miserable. Like that, these people's life also become miserable if they have atisneha, atiprasangaha kurvan vindeta santapam. They also get santapam, sorrow. Next shloka. Now, what is that sorrowful story of Pisian? Namak theriyum inda kada, but nyapakam illa avladha. We don't remember that. Now, Dattatreya reminds us. I learned a lesson from these Pisians. Kapotah kachanaranyem krutanidom vanaspatam kapotya bharyaya sardham उवास कतिचित् समाः कश्चित् अरण्ये. ஒரு ஒரு ஊரிலோ ஒரு ஒரு ராஜன் அனகா அனகா ஒரு ஊரு, ஆ ஊரில் ஒரு ராஜு உன்னாடுன்னு கதை சின்ன வயசில் பாட்டி தாத்தால இந்த கதை சொன்னாரும். Till today also we are like that only. We love to listen kada. Dattatreya knows that, Krishna knows that. That's why we are listening now. Okay. Kaschit arane, in one forest. So what happened? Kapotaha, one pigeon
कपोतया कपोतया
विद अनदर पीजियन कपोतया मीन्स वाइफ पीजियन फीमेल पीजियन कपोतया भार्यया भार्यया हु इज इट्स वाइफ दैट मेल पीजियन हैज गॉट इट्स वाइफ द कपोती विद दैट कपोतया भार्या हुच इज द वाइफ स्टेइंग देर सार्धम उवास अलॉन्ग विद दैट पीजियन अलॉन्ग विद दैट कपोत्या सार्धम अलॉन्ग विद दैट पीजियन उवास इट वॉज लिविंग उवास आर लिट बिकॉज हैपेंड लॉन्ग एगो आई सॉ दैट आई हर्ड एंड लाइक दैट सार्धम उवास When it was living, how many years? Kati, katichit samaha, so many years. Samaha means years. Katichit, many years. Where they lived in Aranyi, Krutanido vanaspatau. There is a big tree. Vanaspati means tree. Vanaspatau on one big tree. Just on big tree they cannot stay because they are wife and husband, they want family, children and all. They want to live together. That's why they created a nest. Kritaneedaha. Kritaneedaha means a nest. Needam means nest. They made a nest on a tree in a forest. So they were living in the forest. In which forest? There was a tree. On that tree there is a needam. The nest they were living. So they are leading a family life. How they are living? The next class we'll see. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम